gonna be a lot of sweating, a lot of maybe crying. But nothing is harder compared with admitting defeat.
There are lots of major physiological demands on the body, which if it goes wrong, can end in real disaster.
It's only a marathon. Do one marathon at a time, and then you've got the rest of the day to get over it.
An ultra run is any race that's longer than a marathon, but some of them are hundreds of kilometres long and go for days, pushing human endurance to the very limit.
My mom and dad, they think I'm crazy. Like, they think, no, this is too extreme. This is impossible. My name is Hal. I'm an ultra marathon runner. I was the fattest kid in the class. And I was always the slowest, I was always the weakest. I started running a lot when I was going through some very difficult chapter of my life. And I find out that the running is a good way to keep me relaxed. Just like when you're running really, really hard, you just kind of forget about everything. You don't have the energy to think about anything. And that's what attracted me a lot.
Hao Zhang has been running marathons for the past 3 years. He's now preparing for his biggest challenge yet, the Big Red Run, a 250-kilometer race through the Simpson Desert.
My girlfriend thought the same way as my parents. It's pretty crazy.
What? 250K in the middle of nowhere? How are you gonna survive?
Thinking back to when I first woke up from my surgery, if anyone had said to me then that I would be running the Big Red Run, I would think they were absolutely crazy.
50-year-old intensive care nurse Merle Carter is a newcomer to ultramarathons. In fact, she only started running 7 years ago.
In 2009, I actually had a brain aneurysm that was bleeding. So I was in hospital for 16 days. Initially, not being allowed to do anything was so frustrating that I just had to get out. So once I was allowed to walk on my own, I took my dog for walks around the block. And then one day I thought, I think I'll just jog just a little bit from one lamppost to the next or one tree to the next, and started doing, you know, runs of different lengths, and eventually found that I could do 5Ks, 10Ks, 21. It was just amazing.
The famous Birchwell track, all the way up.
Merle's husband Kevin will be her support team as the race kicks off in the outback town of Birdsville in Queensland.
My plan for Birdsville is going to be very alcoholic. My friend and I, we're taking a lot of beers, we're taking a lot of red wine, and we're taking a lot of port.
In the early 2000s, ultra running was a sport on the fringes, pursued by just a few hundred hardcore athletes. Its rise in popularity has been meteoric. There are now more than 10,000 people competing in Australian ultras every year. But are we built for this kind of endurance?
There's no doubt that we evolved to run and that we are an incredibly athletic ape. Running is really a feature that defines us as a species. What our ancestors probably did was undertook, you know, sort of long journeys through the day where they in fact took an unusual style of hunting where they would chase down prey over long periods of time. And we're the only species really that's capable of doing this kind of hunting activity.
Is ultra endurance running natural? Sure, there's probably an element of evolution. Did we have artificial finish lines and distances we had to cover? Probably not. There's a real risk. There are issues around hydration, particularly hyponatremia. So that's where the athletes or the individuals replace a lot of the fluid that they're drinking, but they don't replace any of the salt. So the worst case scenario of hyponatremia would be organ failure, cardiac arrest, liver failure, kidney failure, general breakdown, which is a real issue.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the Big Red Run 2016.
It's dawn in Birdsville on the first day of the race. The Big Red Run is one of the toughest ultramarathons in Australia, if not the world. This group of more than 70 athletes will run on loose sand for the next 5 days, tackling dunes as high as 40 metres.
I think for me, one of the hardest things to cope with when you do an ultra run, it's not to go off like a crazy person and, you know, run your fastest. So you have to really learn, you know, like the tortoise and the hare story.
when you're running really, really hard, you just kind of forget about everything. You don't have the energy to think about anything.
Merle and Howe finished the 42 kilometres on day one without a hitch. But overnight, something unexpected happens, a downpour in the desert.
Terrible conditions. Everybody got soaked. Every time you lifted your foot, it was like lifting 2 kilograms on each foot because of the mud.
It's really tough. It's really pushing the limit. Just have to have a lot of mind power, willpower to fight the pain on the legs, the pain, the weakness of the mind sometimes.
The run is suspended for a day. With a break in the weather, the race begins again.
Come hell or high water, I have to get to the end. If I have to crawl my way across that finish line, I'm going to do it.
But the conditions have taken a toll. Over the next 2 days, several runners drop out of the race. But after 5 days and more than 200 kilometres, Howe is among the first to cross the finish line in Birdsville. His time puts him in the top 20, but right now, he's got other things on his mind.
So I decided to propose to my girlfriend. It feels absolutely amazing.
Merle is not too far behind, with a running time of 33 hours, despite picking up an injury on the way.
I think I might have caught a rock, and I just face planted smack into the stones, into the rocks, and I broke my two front teeth.
What do you think of that, Kev?
Crazy bitch.
Running has changed my life so much. It's just a whole amazing new way of life. I hope I run until I'm 100 years old.